In this video, I'm answering 5 questions on selective attention. What is selective attention? What's an example of selective attention? How does selective attention work? Why is selective attention important? And how can we measure selective attention? Let's get to it.
1. What's selective attention?
We are constantly bombarded by an endless array of internal and external stimuli, thoughts, and emotions. Given this abundance of available data, it's amazing that we make sense of anything. In varying degrees of efficiency, we have developed the ability to focus on what's important while blocking out the rest. That's what selective attention is.
It's the process of directing our awareness to relevant stimuli while ignoring irrelevant stimuli in the environment. 2. What's an example of selective attention? An example of selective attention is when you carefully listen to what your teacher is saying while you ignore your classmate's quiet conversation next to you. 3. How does selective attention work?
There are 2 major models describing how visual attention works and 1 experiment which describes how auditory attention works. Let's start with the models describing visual attention.
Number 1. The spotlight model. The spotlight model works much like it sounds. It proposes that visual attention works similar to that of a spotlight. Psychologist William James suggested that this spotlight includes a focal point in which things are viewed clearly. The area surrounding this focal point, known as the fringe, is still visible but not clearly seen. Finally, the area outside of the fringe area of the spotlight is known as the margin. Number 2. The zoom lens model. The second approach is known as the zoom lens model. While it contains all the same elements of the spotlight model, it also suggests that we're able to increase or decrease the size of our focus, much like the zoom lens of a camera. However, a larger focus area also results in slower processing since it includes more information, and as a result, the limited attentional resources must be distributed over a larger area in order to take everything in.
And we're moving on to the experiment describing how auditory attention works.
Psychologist Colin Cherry performed some of the best known experiments on auditory attention. He investigated how people are able to track certain conversations while tuning others out, a phenomenon he referred to as the cocktail party effect.
In these experiments, Cherry presented 2 auditory messages at the same time, one to each ear. Then he asked the participants to pay attention to a particular message and then repeat back what they had heard. He discovered that the participants were able to easily pay attention to one message and repeat it, but when they were asked about the contents of the other message, they were unable to say anything about it.
Cherry found that when he suddenly switched contents of the unattended message, such as changing from English to German mid-message, or suddenly playing it backward, very few of the participants even noticed.
What's intriguing here is that if the speaker of the unattended message was switched from male to female, or vice versa, or if the message was swapped with a 400 Hz tone, the participants always noticed the change.
4. Why is selective attention important? Selective attention is important because it allows our brains to work more effectively. Selective attention acts as a filter to ensure that the brain works best in relation to its tasks. 5. How can we measure selective attention? Selective attention can be measured with the test of everyday attention by using everyday materials. The test, which was founded in 1994, can be conducted on people between the ages of 18 to 80 and comprises 8 subsets, which represent everyday tasks. An example of a subset is elevator counting, where you listen to a series of tones and must indicate a floor number. This information came from these websites. You'll find these links below this video.
Subscribe to my channel and watch this series from the start. Next Friday, I'll be interviewing Matthew Lenwood, a healthcare worker from Long Island, on what it's like to struggle with mental illness when you're Black in modern-day America. Be sure to watch that interview. Till then, I only want to say 3 things. Thank you for watching. Have a great day, and bye for now.